Hey, what's up everyone, and once again, welcome back to Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. Last time, we finished up Mirror Mode using Baby Luigi, I think, and this time, we are going to be starting up the newest racing class added to Mario Kart, added in Mario Kart 8, 200cc. Crazy fast, braking is crucial. This can go one of two ways, and we're probably going to see both. Okay. First off, kart combination, we're going to be using the Mi, which is of course going to be my Mi, and we're going to use the brand new amiibo suit added to this game, which is the Splatoon or Inkling one. And we are going to be using a combination recommended by ChanMan2023 on the Mirror Egg Cup. We are going to be using the jet bike, the monster wheels, and he said any glider, so let's use the gold one. And that is our setup. That's our stats. Let's try this out. And we're of course taking on the 200cc Mushroom Cup with Mario Kart Stadium, Water Park, Sweet Sweet Canyon, and Thwomp Ruins. Let's do this. So, first off, I actually really like this Mii racing suit. Second, why does my Mii look fatter than usual? And third, look at the speed. Hold up. Let us get a bit of speed going. And, yep, it's a little ridiculous. Now, this is the Mushroom Cup, so I'm hoping this isn't going to be too tough. However, when I played 200cc on this game, after not playing it on 8 for a while and then jumping into Deluxe, you know, when I first got the game, I forgot to hit the brakes. I sucked at it, and I could not win Grand Prix for the life of me, but somehow I managed to get all the triple star rankings eventually. But it can be tough, and you definitely do have to hit the brakes on certain corners. Like right here, we want to get the sharp turn, gotta hold down the brakes, like so. And certain controller setups, like I believe if you're using, well not on the Switch of course, but if you use the Wii Remote on its side on Wii U, you can't brake, because the brake button, the one button on the Wii Remote, is the drift button, so you can't hit the brakes, which is kind of a problem if you're playing 200cc. So that's why I highly recommend you get the Pro Controller or anything like that. And oh god, a blue shell. Okay, I didn't check the acceleration on this thing, or I didn't remember the stats too well, but see how we do, because Toadette's right behind her. She's got two mushrooms circling her. I'm surprised. Oh, she's probably going to take a shortcut down here. I think this is a bomb. Oh, never mind. She used up her mushrooms already, because she's an idiot, I guess. All right, should take this last corner. Did we win? Oh, God. I was looking at the wrong place on the map, but we got it. First place. So, yeah, it's a fast mode, and it's only going to get harder. Another thing you may have noticed is the length of this episode. It's probably shorter than most. Or maybe not too short, because I did have a bit of time for setup at the beginning, but these races are going to fly by, as I'm sure you can tell. Because 200cc, that was a cool kick myself, is a little ridiculous. Right then, when we used the mushroom, that it was even faster than regular driving. See, we've been in this race, what, 20 seconds, and we're already almost done with the first lap? We're right on the last stretch here. 1, 2, 3. It took about 3 seconds to clear that final stretch just then, so yeah, these episodes are gonna go by a little bit quicker, meaning the topics we talk about will probably just be like maybe one topic per episode now. Or it will just be me screaming because I can't win. But currently we're not doing too bad. Ultra Mini Turbo, look at this. Ultra Mini Turbo in 200cc. It's a little crazy. Hit those brakes! There we go. Now, it's a little odd actually starting off with the jet bike, because I used to always use the jet bike. That was my main vehicle when I mained Metal Mario. I don't really use it too much now, but it's an inside drifting bike, so it's just a little strange to have this be the first thing we're using in 200cc, because I can almost guarantee My brain's gonna get used to using the inside drift after this first Grand Prix, and then we're gonna get into the next cup, and we're gonna have an outside drifting vehicle, and I'm just gonna suck. I'm gonna royally suck at it, but we'll see. That is another race in the bag. We're almost 6 minutes deep into the episode, and we've already knocked out two races and done an intro and picked everything, and it's gonna go by quick. Race number three. Okay, sweet, sweet Canyon. Let's see what you've got. My outfit and my bike kind of blend in with this place. I didn't even realize I'd matched my outfit to my vehicle. It's kind of neat. All right, hit the brakes. There we go. Second corner, and we're already having to hit the brakes. Now, right here, I'm going to try for the Ultra Mini Turbo. Take it a little wide so we can still cut back in a bit. There it is. God damn it. I'll be honest. I love 200cc. I think it's a great addition, and I kind of wish that they had added it to Worldwides, so you could, you know, there's an option for 200cc Worldwides, because you can do it in, please no, oh god, I panicked and used my Super Horn on a red shell, damn it. You can do it in, like, friend rooms, you can set up 200cc Grand Prix, which I did do a while back on the old Online Races series before Worldwides took over. But since Worldwides is just so much better than doing that, and you know, you actually get VR out of it, and you play with random people around the globe, and we are hitting all the walls right now, I just kind of wish there was an option for 200cc in Worldwides, just like there's an option for DLC and non-DLC races in Worldwides. And okay, this is gonna be fun. Drop that bomb. I think I hit somebody with it. I was just trying to avoid the red shell, and there's a bullet now, and apparently we're in third place. I don't know when that happened, and I'm screwing everything up, and getting the mushroom from the Inkling didn't clear off the bloop. We got a bit of catch up to do in this last section. Okay, let's see how we do. We got the Inkling girl right there with a banana. Gonna keep my distance. There we go. She got rid of that. Who is in first right now? Hit the brakes. Use the brakes. Okay, we're back in first. We do this? No, piranha plant! I go through the shortcut. Don't go on this off the side. Okay. We like crossed the finish line at a 90 degree angle to it. Are you getting a little inkling of how these races are gonna go later on? Just wait for Rainbow Road. I can't wait to see what combination we get for the Special Cup. That's gonna be great. You know, I've never noticed that bird's nest before that was in the water area of this course. I just noticed it on top of that pillar just now. Koopa, why are you going faster than the speed of sound right now? Quickest hedgehog around. God damn, that's some rubber band AI for you. I guess it really does affect him in 200cc even more. And then they just have to slam on the brakes once they realize they're going too far ahead. I don't like rubber band AI, as I'm sure you know, but I kind of wish they had a way of making the AI, well, I'm sure they do, of making the AI like it would be if you were just playing against human players. And this red shell can't catch up to me. It's struggling. Oh, when did I lose my red shell? All right then. So see, that's the thing. Even though we've got, we go so fast and we're able to pull away from the pack, the second you get hit, everybody's going to be right behind you. So it really doesn't make a difference to how good you are in 200cc, I'd say, because if you get hit by one item, everyone's going just as fast as you, and sometimes even faster because of the rubber band AI. In fact, I don't even want to risk the shortcut this time. But I don't know. We've got a decent enough lead now, or we would have a decent enough lead if we were in 150cc, but right now, that's probably just the tiniest gap, and an unnecessary red shell. And I just realized I never pointed out where the bird's nest is. And we're at zero coins too. Hold up. Oh, we need to get more of those. I want to go even faster. All right, look on the right of this swamp. There's a bird's nest right there. I've never noticed that before. I don't know what kind of bird it's for. Maybe Kleptolocondor or something like that. It's about the right size. All right, final stretch. Koopa is getting close. With 6 coins. Don't hit the pillar. Alright, I think we're good. Koopa's just got bananas. He can't do anything. Not bad. Alright, first place on all 4 races in the first 200cc cup. I think that's a decent start, even though Sweet Sweet Canyon, we almost came second because there was a 90 degree angle to the finish line. But not bad. Hopefully that's an omen for how everything's gonna go. But probably not. And we end off the highlight reel with my Mii getting hit in the butt with a red shell and opening his eyes the widest I think I've ever seen. Not bad. 60 points, triple star, gold trophy. I'm not gonna complain about that. And of course, with that, that is gonna go ahead and do it for this episode of Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. Next time we're heading back into 200cc with some kind of setup. I think I already have one in mind. And it involves monster wheels again, so let's see what happens. And we're going to be taking on the 200cc Flower Cup. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like and let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.